channel, and I must apologize today if I sound a bit nasally. I haven't been feeling well past couple days. Don't worry, was not corona, just a nasty virus. But let's get started. So we have today this high yield behavioral science fourth edition book by Barbara Adam, and we're gonna read a section of this book on some high yield behavioral science topics for the USMLE. And as it says here, this book is designed to 1. Provide a quick review of behavioral science. Great. 2. Help equip you for the behavioral science questions on the USMLE. And lastly, clarify difficult concepts. Okay. Let's begin. And I actually wanted to start with this section dealing with sleep. It's chapter 7 in this book. And I hope you can see that. Hold it up over here. Chapter 7, Sleep. First section, the awake state and the normal sleep state. Okay, we have here a patient snapshot. A 38-year-old man, for the past 6 months, has felt tired all the time, is evaluated in a sleep laboratory. In the interview with the physician, the patient notes that during those months, he has had frequent thoughts of suicide, lack of appetite, resulting in a 25-pound weight loss, and little interest in activities such as fishing that he formerly enjoyed. What characteristics of sleep state and architecture are likely to be seen in this patient? All right, and here we'll be able to get the answers from this chapter. Answer at the end of the chapter. So here we have it. The awake state, the sleep state, and sleep architecture. Okay, awake state. Beta and alpha waves characterize the EEG of an awake individual. Here we'll have a look at this table here in a moment. We'll see all of these different waves of the EEG. The sleep state. Normal sleep consists of stages 1, 2, 3, and 4. As well as rapid eye movement, REM sleep. Each stage of sleep is associated with particular brain wave patterns. Sleep architecture, the changes in sleep stages that occur throughout the night, produce a structure known as sleep architecture. 1. Measures of sleep architecture are sleep latency, which is the time from going to bed to falling asleep. REM latency, which is the time from falling asleep to the first REM. per amount of time spent in bed. 2, sleep architecture and percentage of time spent in each sleep stage change with age and in depression. Okay. Use of alcohol, benzodiazepines, and barbiturates is associated with decreased REM and delta sleep. Neurotransmitters are associated with the production of sleep. See this in a table. Okay. Let's have a look at this table here before we move on to the next section of sleep disorders. So, we have here the different characteristics. The characteristics of the awake state and of sleep stages. Sleep stage awake, we have this associated, hold this up, beta pattern. And its characteristics are active mental concentration. All right, and we also have in awake state alpha EEG patterns, which is relaxation with eyes closed. Now, stage one, we'll start seeing in about 5% of sleep time in young adults, we'll start seeing these theta waves over here, right? And the characteristics of that are that it's the lightest stage of sleep, characterized by peacefulness, slowed pulse, and respiration, decreased blood pressure, and episodic body movements. Okay. Moving on to stage two, we have the start of sleep spindles and K complexes as shown here. Right, 45% of sleep time in young adults, characterized by the largest percentage of sleep time and bruxism, tooth grinding. Okay, now moving on to stages 3 and 4. We have delta, which is slow wave sleep, as you can see here. You can see here. 25% decreases with age. Now, this is the deepest, most relaxed stage of sleep. Sleep disorders such as night tremors, sleepwalking, called somnambulism, and bedwetting and uresis may occur. Okay, REM, sleep stage, we find these sawtooth, beta, alpha, and theta waves in the EEG. 25%, although decreases with age, and increases in depression. Now, we have here that periods occur every 90 minutes, dreaming, penile and clitoral erection, increased cardiovascular activity, absence of skeletal muscle movement. REM deprivation leads to REM rebound and transient psychiatric symptoms such as anxiety or psychosis. This was the first section. Now, very good, guys. Very, very good. Let's move on to the second section here on sleep disorders. Sleep disorders. We have here a classification of sleep disorders. We have here, according to the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, okay, the DSM, there are two major categories of sleep disorders. These two categories are dysomnias and parasomnias. Dysomnias are characterized by problems in the timing, quality, or amount of sleep. These disorders include insomnia, narcolepsy, breathing-related sleep disorder, sleep apnea, as well as circadian rhythm sleep disorder, sleeping at inappropriate times, and hypersomnia, oversleeping. While parasomnias are characterized by abnormalities in physiology or in behavior associated with sleep, they include sleep terror, sleepwalking, both occurring in delta sleep, and nightmare disorder, repeated episodes of frightening dreams occurring in REM sleep. Okay. Management of sleep disorders. Management options for insomnia, narcolepsy, sleep apnea, and sleep terror disorder are described in Table 7.4. Let's look at these tables. First, we have this figure, which shows the different sleep stages per the normal young adult. This is what we call the sleep architecture. This is in a normal young adult. Okay, as we see here, awake. Various sleep stages here, going down up like this. Okay. Now, let's look at the characteristics of sleep in depression and aging, okay? So we have here sleep latency. About 10 minutes in a normal young adult, over 10 minutes in a depressed young adult, and over 10 minutes in a normal elderly adult. The REM latency is about 90 minutes in a normal young adult, about 45 minutes in a depressed young adult, and in a normal elderly adult, about 90 minutes. Sleep efficiency now, that's about 100% in a normal young adult. Under 100% in a depressed young adult, and as well under 100% in a normal elderly adult. Percentage delta, about 25% in a normal young adult, under 25% in a depressed young adult, and under 25% in a normal elderly adult. And lastly, percentage REM is about 25% in a normal young adult, over 25% in a depressed young adult, and under 25% in a normal elderly transmitters and sleep. We've got two big actions here. We've got the neurotransmitters that promote sleep, and the ones that promote wakefulness. Wakefulness. Sleep and wakefulness. Okay. Ones that promote sleep are serotonin, acetylcholine. Ones that promote wakefulness, norepinephrine and dopamine. So, serotonin will increase total sleep time and slow wave sleep. Damage to the dorsal raphe nucleus decreases both of these measures. Depression is associated with low serotonin and reduced sleep quality and slow wave sleep. Antidepressants increase serotonin and improve sleep quality. Acetylcholine, okay, its effect is activity in the reticular formation increases total sleep time and REM sleep. Anticholinergics, for example, atropine, increase REM sleep. Cholinomimetics, like physostigmine, increase REM sleep. Okay. Now, which ones promote wakefulness? The norepinephrine. Its effect is that it decreases both total sleep time and REM sleep. Anxious patients have trouble falling asleep. Dopamine. Mania and other psychotic illnesses are associated with wakefulness. Management with antipsychotics, which block DA receptors, improves sleep. All right, let's move on. This next table here. Okay. Very good, guys. Very, very, very good. So, this is a table of sleep disorders and their management in order of highest to lowest utility. We've got insomnia, narcolepsy, breathing related sleep disorder, sleep apnea, insomnia. Okay, patient snapshot, all right? Patient snapshot. A 25-year-old medical student complains that for most nights during the past year, he lies awake in bed for 2 hours before falling asleep at night. During the day, he is tired and frequently makes errors in his chart work and on exams. The characteristics, difficulty falling asleep or staying asleep that occurs for at least 1 month and leads to sleepiness during the day or results in problems fulfilling social or occupational obligations. Occurs in up to 30% of the U.S. population. It is associated with the use of caffeine, withdrawal from alcohol, anxiety disorders, and mood disorders. And its management is avoidance of caffeine, development of a sleep ritual, improvement of sleep hygiene. For example, establish a fixed sleep and wake schedule. Relaxation techniques, non-benzodiazepine sleep agent, for example, Zolpidem, Ambien, Zaloplon, Sonata, Esopiclone, Lunesta, Ramelteon, Rosarin, stimulant drug. Okay, that was insomnia. Okay, let's move on to narcolepsy. Let's see a patient snapshot. A 30-year-old woman reports strange perceptual experiences as she is falling asleep. Hypnagogic hallucinations. She also reports that she is unable to move for about a minute after she wakes up, sleep paralysis, and had a few car accidents when she fell asleep while driving. Characteristics are sleep attacks in which the individual falls asleep suddenly during the day. Short REM latency. Hypnagogic hallucinations occur on falling asleep. Hypnopompic hallucinations occur on waking up. Cataplexy, loss of all muscle tone with a strong emotional stimulus. Sleep paralysis, inability to move for a few seconds on waking. Okay? And its management is stimulant drugs such as modafinil, provigil, if cataplexy is present, an antidepressant or sodium oxybate, Xyrem is added, and timed daytime naps. Okay. And we have breathing related sleep disorder. Okay. Sleep apnea. Patient snapshot, 45-year-old overweight man is tired every day. His wife reports that he snores and seems to stop breathing at times during the night. Okay, now, characteristics. Breathing cessation for many brief periods during sleep. It may be central with no respiratory effort or obstructive airway obstruction, which is more common. Okay. Cannot sleep deeply because anoxia causes awakenings during the night, leading to chronic tiredness. More common in men in middle age and in the obese. Related to headaches, pulmonary hypertension, respiratory acidosis, depression, and sudden death, particularly in the elderly and in infants. Again, the management. Weight loss if overweight, a mask with a device providing continuous positive airway pressure, CPAP. Okay. Respiratory stimulant like hydroxyprogesterone, acetate, so-called Provera, fluoxetine, Prozac, and protriptyline, Vivactil. Okay. Surgery like a tracheostomy or less invasive procedure. Let's continue on the next page. Okay, and this last one over here, we have sleep terror disorder. Again, patient snapshot. A 4-year-old girl's parents report that she often screams in her sleep during the night. When they try to waken her, she sits up in bed and opens her eyes, but does not respond to them and has no memory of the incident the next day. Okay, characteristics. Recurrent nighttime periods of extreme fright and screaming, most common in children, in contrast to nightmares which occur during REM sleep. This occurs during slow wave sleep. No memory of the arousal or dreaming. Usually normal, but may be an early sign of temporal lobe epilepsy if it starts in adolescence. Okay, management, to reassure parents that occasional night terrors are normal in young children. Rarely, use of a benzodiazepine in small doses at bedtime. All right, and now the answer here to our question at the beginning. We have a sleep architecture of this depressed patient reveals a short REM latency, reduced delta sleep, increased REM sleep, and many nighttime awakenings, leading to poor sleep efficiency and daytime sleepiness. The patient snapshots in table 7-4 are explained in the text of that table, which we've done. Okay. I want to just note that this is not meant to be a practical guide to these medical disorders, but simply as a study guide to the USMLE. So, I want to wish everyone a good night's sleep, or good luck studying, or good luck dreaming, and I hope that it's a sleep with a long REM latency, with increased delta sleep, with increased REM sleep. Or any other form of sleep, which will be beneficial to you, and you'll be able to wake up feeling refreshed. Everyone, thank you for joining me.